Hello, everybody. Thank you for tuning in today. My name is Randy Calistri-Yeh. I play the cello. This is Millie Calistri-Yeh. She plays the violin. Together, we are the Synergismus Duo. We are based in Florham Park, New Jersey, but we play all over the Great Garden State. And today, we have a special concert for the South Brunswick Public Library. Thank you very much to Chris Carbone for setting this concert up. And like most library events, this one is sponsored by the Friends of the SBPL. And in addition, there is funding provided by the Middlesex County Board of Chosen Freeholders through a grant award from the Middlesex County Cultural and Arts Trust Fund. We thank them very much for their generous support of the arts. That first song that we played was Be Our Guest, from the Disney show Beauty and the Beast. But today's music is all about dance. We are going to look at musical numbers involving dance spanning four different continents, spanning four different centuries. And we are going to start with a very unusual choice for dance music in the springtime. We are going to start with Greensleeves, the famous Christmas carol. This was written by Richard Jones in 1580 in England, and its original title was A New Northern Ditty of Ye Lady Green Sleeves, and it had absolutely nothing to do with Christmas. The Lady Green Sleeves was a young amorous woman who was singing about her lover and his advances, and this was a country tune that was done to a Morris dance. The English have been dancing Morris dances since the 1400s, and it started off as a court dance, and it eventually made its way out into the countryside. And it was 100 years after this song was written that it finally became associated with Christmas time. So here is Greensleeves, a Morris dance from England. So the same time in the 1580s that the English were doing their Morris dances, the French had their whole own set of courtly dances. They had sarabands, they had jigs, they had gavottes, and these are the sorts of dances that you think of when you are picturing the men in the powdered wigs, the women in the long flowing gowns, dancing through dancing through a courtyard somewhere. And this particular gavotte that we are going to be performing for you is a more modern version of it. This was written by the Russian composer Reinhold Gliere in 1909. It was actually written for violin and cello. And you're going to hear something a little unexpected in the middle of this song. It's going to sound like there are some bagpipes droning away. That is actually supposed to happen. In a traditional gavotte, there is a middle section that's called a musette. And the musette is supposed to sound like the droning of French bagpipes. I'll bet you didn't even know the French had bagpipes, but yes, they did. And you can listen to them in this gavotte by Reinhold Gliere. Continue heading east, and our next stop is Hungary, and we are going to perform a Csardas for you. The Csardas is the national dance of Hungary. It is a gypsy dance. It's very passionate and romantic. I'm not quite sure how people dance to this because the tempo changes all over the place. It starts off very slow, it gets faster, suddenly it stops and it gets slow, and then it takes off at the end and goes super fast. But they manage to stay with it somehow. There's a lot of room for improvisation, for different styles coming into this music. Probably the most famous Csardas today is the one we're going to play. It is simply called Csardas, and it was written by the Italian composer Vittorio Monti in 1904. This is almost exactly the same time that Gliere, the Russian composer, was borrowing French, old French music, and Monti, the Italian composer, is borrowing old Hungarian music. Here is Monti's Csardas.
Thank you.
thunderous applause in the background. This one just gets so exciting at the end. Okay, our next stop on this world journey is Istanbul, Turkey, formerly known as Constantinople. And this is a city that sits right on the border between Europe and Asia. Half of the city is in Europe, half the city is in Asia. And it has been one of the cultural crossroads. It's been part of the Silk Road trading path for thousands of years. At one point, Constantinople was the capital of the Russian Empire under Emperor Constantine. That's how it got its name, Constantinople. And as people would travel through the city from all over the known world, they would pick up different cultural pieces and take them back to their homelands. And one of the cultural pieces that did a lot of traveling was a Turkish song called Uskudar, or Katibim, depending on where you're coming from. And in Turkish, the song was originally about a wealthy woman and her male secretary that she's romantically involved with. And as this spread through the various Balkan countries, sometimes it was a love song, sometimes it was a battle song, sometimes it was a religious song, but it always kept the same melody. I've seen this done as a belly dance. I've also seen this done as a processional folk dance where all of the girls and the women are holding fancy colored umbrellas. It's very, very picturesque. So this is our arrangement of Uskudar, or Katibim. China, and this is in the remote mountainous region in the northwest corner of China, near the border with Tibet. And the song is called Muyang Gu Niang, or the Shepherd Girl, or Shepherdess. And this is a traditional Chinese folk song, and it is sometimes performed as a Tibetan folk dance with very colorful robes and dresses that they wear. This is Muyang Gu Niang. We've played this before on traditional Chinese instruments. Millie plays it on the arhu, the Chinese two-stringed violin, and I accompany her on the guzheng, the Chinese zither. And today we're going to be doing it on the violin and cello. So we're going to come back to Europe now, specifically to Austria, and we're going to be looking at one of the most romantic and elegant of dances, and this is the Viennese waltz. The waltz actually started in the 1500s, and it was always a couples dance, and it was always a spinning around in circles dance from the very beginning. But just like the gavotte in its time was somewhat scandalous because the men and the women actually touched when they were dancing, the waltz was even more so because they're almost hugging each other. And it took quite a while for the upper class to become more accepting of this. Johann Strauss Jr. was a large influence in getting them to be more accepting of this. He was known as the Waltz King, and he wrote over 500 waltzes and polkas and other dance music during his life. And he's the main reason why the waltz is so loved in Vienna. Probably his most famous waltz is the Blue Danube Waltz, An der schönen blauen Donau. And we're going to be doing our arrangement of the Blue Danube Waltz by Johann Strauss Jr.
Thank you.
You remember back in the beginning when we did the French gavotte, and I said that there were several types of French dances in the courts, including the jig. The jig escaped from France at some point, wandered around Europe for a while, and eventually settled in Scotland, where the jig became the jig, a very lively folk dance. And even today, if you go into a local pub in Scotland or England or Ireland, you are likely to come across a group of musicians, singers, dancers, all performing jigs and reels and other related dances. And if you happen to be in Scotland and you're playing at closing time, the tradition is that you will end your set of music with the Bonnie Banks of Loch Lomond, played very slow, very sad, And that's the signal that everybody is supposed to finish up their pint of ale and head for the doors because it's closing time. We're going to do a set called the Haymakers Jig Set. Okay, we finally made it to America. This is our first American dance piece. It's from 1909, and it was written by Scott Joplin, the great piano rag composer. He was known as the King of Ragtime, and he wrote 44 piano rags during his life. Many of the rags were just songs to play on the piano. Some of them were marches. And some of them were dances, usually a ragtime two-step that you would do to this, like a cakewalk. And the one that we're going to be performing today is Country Club, a piano rag by Scott Joplin. ¶¶ Of the blues, you end up with jazz. And jazz is the basis for all American popular music that followed it. It started off in the 1920s and went through the 30s, 40s, 50s, still going strong in the 60s. And the dance associated with jazz is swing. And there are various versions of jitterbug, starting with the Lindy Hop and the Charleston back in the 20s, lots of other variations that came along during the years. We're going to be playing a big band swing number. It is a Duke Ellington standard called Don't Get Around Much Anymore.
Thank you.
places to see and hear and experience American dance music is on Broadway. And we're going to take a look at a Broadway show from 1957. This is Leonard Bernstein's West Side Story. It's basically the retelling of Shakespeare's Romeo and Juliet, but instead of the Montagues and the Capulets, we have the Sharks and the Jets battling it out for turf on the west side of Manhattan. And you have an Italian gang, and you have a Puerto Rican gang. And for the Puerto Ricans, Bernstein wrote all sorts of wonderful Latin-inspired dance songs for them. The two that we're going to play are Maria, which is in the style of a Cuban habanero, and America, which is a rousing Mexican huapango. Two Latin dances from West Side Story.
Thank you.
going to head south now, way down south, about as far south as you can go in Argentina, where we're going to be looking at some tangos. The tango is the national dance of Argentina, and it started in the 1880s in the rough bars of the waterfront towns in Argentina. And it was this really unique blend of black African slave melodies, the native South American rhythms, different melodies from the European sailors and settlers, and they all came together, and what emerged from this mix was the tango. We're going to be playing two tangos for you. The first is the most popular tango in all of Argentina, El Choclo. And the second one is Por Una Cabeza. And this one has been featured in many movies and TV shows, most famously in Scent of a Woman with Al Pacino, and most infamously in True Lies, where you get to watch Arnold Schwarzenegger attempt to dance the tango with Jamie Lee Curtis. Two tangos from Argentina. Thank you. very much for listening to us today, and a huge thanks to the South Brunswick Public Library for their generous support. We hope that we will be able to play for you in person sometime real soon, but for now we are going to end this concert, as we end all of our concerts, with America the Beautiful.